Hi everyone, my name is Cortland and you're watching SU Aviation. And today I want to talk about what a restricted ATP is and why you might want to have one. To start off, what is an ATP? An ATP is an airline transport pilot certificate that will allow you to fly for either the airlines or corporate with about 1,500 flight hours. A restricted ATP can be earned by training through a federal Part 141 program. A Part 141 program usually is associated with a higher education or a collegiate flight program. So you may earn an associate degree or a bachelor's degree while flying. And you can major or have a minor in aviation. With an associate's degree, you will be able to reduce your total flight time to 1,250 flight hours, where a bachelor's degree will allow you to reduce your time to 1,000 flight hours. In order to qualify for a restricted ATP, you will need to complete your instrument and your commercial flight training certificates through an approved Part 141 flight program. You are able to transfer to different institutions, but there are some technicalities, so it's best to pick one Part 141 program and just stick with it. One of these technicalities is the aircraft that you learn to fly in. Changing airframes this soon in your training can be challenging. With your restricted ATP, until you reach 1,500 hours in industry, your piloting operations will be supervised. You are not released into the field just yet, young Padawan.
I need to see your ATP.
You don't need to see my ATP.
We don't need to see his ATP.
Does the restricted ATP apply to helicopter pilots too? Unfortunately, it doesn't. This restriction only benefits the category of airplane pilots, but there is an ATP certificate for the rotor category, such as helicopters. We hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching. See you next time.